Uses of spherical mirrors, use of concave mirror and uses of convex mirror. Okay, so we will study now what is the uses. The first one, so concave mirror, how it will show the image? It shows the images big, it will show the small images as big. Okay, so that is why, so it will show small images as a big images. Okay, concave mirror is like this. So for example, so here is the object. Okay, object is here, but the image formation will be very big. Okay, so it will show the small images as a big images. That is why they use the concave mirrors in the torch, searchlights, headlights of vehicles. Headlights of vehicles means that lights before the vehicles, na? So they use, so to obtain the parallel beam of light. So from the torch, the light will be coming like parallel, like this, na? So because of that, the small images will show as a big images. So but actually in the torch light, there will be only small light will be there. But it will show as a big brightness, it will show. Okay, so they will use there. And they also employed shaving mirrors to obtain large image of face. And then it is used to obtain magnified image of tooth. Magnified means big images of tooth. So in the hospitals, the dentists, those who check the teeth in the hospital, they use this concave mirrors to see the teeth. Okay, large sized concave mirrors are used to focus sunlight in the solar power plants. And but the, what are the uses of the convex mirror? This mirror that you see on the side of a car, which the drivers use to see the images of vehicles. On the side of the vehicles, and there is a mirror is there. So that mirror, they use the convex mirror. Convex mirror, how it will show means, convex mirror will show the big images as a small images. Okay, it will show the big to small opposite. That is why you see in the side of the vehicles, they use the convex mirror. So in the convex mirror, it will show the big images as a small images. Okay, so vehicles will be very far, but inside the mirror of the vehicles, side mirrors, we see as a small lorry is coming, but big lorry. So that is why they use there. Okay, so they are used to rear view mirror because they always from erect image, always convex means the sorry convex mirror is this side, na, curving outside, curve is outside. So this convex mirror always shows the virtual image. Virtual image means always straight images. Okay, it will not be inverted. Inverted means upside down. It will not show the real images which are upside down. Okay, but the disadvantage is that the image is smaller than the object. Okay, what is the disadvantage means? The convex mirrors always will show the small big things as a small things. Since they are curved in a manner bulging outwards, since they are bulging outwards, they always show the big as a small things. Okay, some supermarkets also they are using these mirrors so that two customers when they are coming, they don't dash each other. Okay, so this is the mirror. So with this we have finished studying about the mirrors. Till now we have studied the reflection in the mirrors. Okay, so reflection in the spherical mirrors. Okay, so reflection means what? Always the rays you see. Always the rays are only straight rays we are getting. Reflection. Always the angle of incident is equal to the angle of refraction. So reflection. Okay, straight lines. So it is only outside only one medium the rays are forming. It is the reflection. So now we are going to see how the refraction takes place in the spherical lenses. Till now we study about the spherical mirrors. Spherical mirrors have two types. One is the concave mirror and convex mirror. And what are the spherical lenses? Also two types. Those are the convex lens and concave lens. Okay, now we are going to study the refraction in the concave lens and the convex lens. Okay, so refraction. Okay, we are going to study the refraction at spherical surfaces. Okay, how the refraction is taking place in the spherical surfaces. Okay, so this is the spherical lenses. Okay, spherical lenses. This is the convex lens, and concave lens is like this. Okay, cave means always inside, curve is inside. Convex means the curve is outside. Okay, so this is the concave lens, and this is a convex lens. And for this for this spherical lenses, what is the difference between the spherical mirrors and spherical lenses? Spherical mirrors are only one curve. Okay, it will be like this, but the spherical lenses are two, like this. Okay, so this is the difference. So when we study, lens is a transparent medium. Okay, transparent medium covered by two sides. At least one of the sides is curved. Such type of lenses either converge a parallel beam of light to point of a diverge the light away. Okay, that means converge means the rays which are coming, parallel rays na. So they meet, they bend and meet at one point. They will be bending and meet at one point. It is called as a converge. And a diverge means all the parallel rays will not meet at one point. They will bend and go the other side. Okay, so it is called as a diverging lens, taking other side, diverging. Diverging, converging means meeting at one point. Okay, it is the converging. Understand? So parallel beam of light. So if a lens has both sides concave, then it is called as a biconcave. Both sides concave means two sides curve is there. So it is the both sides concave. It is the biconcave lens. If a lens has a both sides bulging outside, okay, so both sides, it is the convex lens. Okay, biconcave, convex or biconvex lens. Okay, and the next one, in the concave lens, this is the concave, cave guha inside. Okay, like that you remember. For example, concave lens, in the middle it is thinner, in the at the edges means outside, it is thicker. Okay, so and the convex lens, in the middle thicker, at the end it is the thinner. Okay, so it will be like this. So some definitions related to the spherical lenses. We study tomorrow. Thank you.